Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to talk about string in JavaScript. Now, if you ask me what is a string, probably I can say it's a class and it's immutable. Now, what was that? Probably you can wait until the video ends to know more about it, so watch fully. Now, we are going to discuss some of the important concepts in string, like few methods here, which are going to help us to complete our test script here, right? Now, let me flip to my VS Code. And as always, we have to create a new file, JavaScript file, and then we have to type some code, and then we have to open our terminal to run that file, right? But instead of doing that, I'm going to show you something new, which is known as Koushik plugin here, right? Now, if you go here, this is your extension tab here, right? Click on that, and in the search, you have to type Q-U-O-K-K-A, Koushik. Now, if you see here, the first one says Koushik.js, right? Here, click on the install and wait for some time, then it will say the extension is enabled globally. That's it, right? Now close this and you can go to your explorer, or else even if you want, you can hide that. Now use Ctrl, Shift and P together to get this pop-up menu here, right? Now here you have to type Koushik, and here you can select either TypeScript or JavaScript. As of now, I'm going to select this JavaScript file, so click on that. Now, please remember, do not save this file, or you no need to give any file extension here, right? Now, as soon as you type, you will get the output. That is the specialty of this Koushik plugin here, okay? Let me give you an example here. So, first thing, we are going to learn about the string, right? So, I can say probably we are going to see the first function, which is toUpperCase, right? But before that, we have to declare a string here, right? Now, there are two ways to declare a string. So, first one, obviously, it is going to be let and some string name here. So, I'm going to give str and equal to within double quotes, single quotes, or even you can use the backticks here to declare a string here, right? So, I'm going to use the single quotes here and I'm going to say welcome to LetCode. Okay, that's it. Now, semicolon is really not necessary here. If you want, you can use, or else you may skip that. Okay. Now to print this, obviously we have to use the console.log, right? So I'm going to use the log shortcut here and enter, and I'm going to call this str here, right? Now if you see, as soon as I log this, I'm able to get the output here itself, right? So that is the specialty of this Koushik plugin. I hope for each and every learner, this is going to be like very handy to them, right? As a learner, you no need to type again, save again and again run, right? Instead of that, you can use this plugin. Okay, now this plugin supports both TypeScript as well as JavaScript, but here we are going to learn JavaScript. Then probably when we learn the TypeScript, we can use the plugin for the same here, right? Now let's move on. Okay, so here we have console.log, which says that welcome to LetCode, right? This is one way of declaring a string. The another way is going to, like, you have to call the constructor here, right? So here I'm going to say let maybe some name here. So let me say as name here and equal to new, then you can call the constructor here, right? Now within the constructor, you have to pass any value, which is going to be my name here, right? Now if I log this, I'm going to get the my name here, right? So it says the string, which is going to be type, and it says that Koushik, right? Now also it's giving us some iterator, which you can see like we are getting so many like 0, 1 from each and every indexes. It's going to give the separate value, right? That's okay, not a problem here. Now if you want to check what is the type actually, so we have str and we have name, right? We are going to check the type of this. Obviously we know this is string, but how do we check in programmatically is there is a keyword called type of, right? So I'm going to log that and type of, and here I'm going to say str, right? Now if you see, this is going to be string. Okay, now let's check the another type as well. So log, and here I'm going to say type of name, right? So it is going to be object. So here we can declare a string using the literal, string literal, or else we can declare the same string using an object by defining the new string constructor here. Okay, now let's check few methods which are most used in our test automation script. So the first one is to convert the character, each and every character, to a uppercase. Okay, for example, let's log str dot to uppercase, right? So to uppercase is the method here. So here it is going to convert all my character, that is each and every character within the string, to the uppercase, right? Now same applies to lowercase as well, where it is going to change all the characters to the lowercase, right? For example, let's say that log here, let me comment this first. Okay, now here I'm going to say str dot to lowercase, right? Now if you see here the w changes to lowercase, right? But here the actual is in uppercase, as well as the l is in uppercase, right? But each and every character has been changed to the lowercase. Okay, so that is what the toLowerCase method is used for, right? Now let me comment this here. Now let's say that I want to find a particular word, or I want to search for particular letter, then we can use the function called includes here, right? So I'm going to log this, and here I'm going to say str.includes, right? Now within the includes you have to pass a value, now like what you're actually searching for, so you have to pass that, right? So here I'm going to say that I'm searching for 2 here, right? Now this is going to return as boolean, either true or false. Okay, so whether the actual string contains this one, okay, so actual string is my welcome to LetCode, where the includes we are searching for a partially, okay, we are searching for the 2 word here, right? So yes, it is available there, so we are getting the value as true. Now let's say that I'm going to add one more O here. Now this is going to be false, because in the string we do not have this string, right? So obviously it is going to be false, right? Now if I search for a character, then also it is going to be true. Now how does it search? Because here also I have a T, and here also I have a T, right? This is obviously going to take the first match here, okay? So if you see the description, or if you read, it is going to say that it is always returns the first matching elements, I mean the characters from the string, right? Okay, let me come on this here. Now let's take another example. So here I'm going to take like maybe words by words, right? So I want to check how many words are there inside the str, right? So for that we have something called split here, right? So I'm going to log this. So log, and here I'm going to say str dot split. Now here, how do we identify the number of words are here, right? So we have to identify based on this space here, right? So using this space we can say, okay, we have 3 words, so 1, 2, and 3. So we are going to split based on that condition here, right? So here I'm going to say within double quotes a space here, right? Now if you see here, it's giving us welcome to and let code in a array of string. So whenever you are going to split a string, it is going to convert that strings into a array, right? Now let's say that I want to print each and every character, I mean each and every word here, right? So how do we do that? We have to obviously store this into another string, and then probably we can use the loop, right? So let's do that. Okay, so here what I'm going to do is I'm going to split that using space, and here I'm going to store this in another string, right? So let's name it as splitted. Sorry for that, splitted, splitted, right? Or maybe we can name it as words here, that will be more appropriate here. And here I'm going to use the for loop, either we can go with the for or for each, right? So I'm going to go use the for each here. So words dot for each, and this is going to give me a callback function, which is going to be one element at a time. And here I'm going to use the arrow syntax, and here I'm going to log this as ELE, right? Now what is callback and how to use these arrow functions, probably you will know in this arrow function in the function video, but this callback I will teach you in another video, right? So if you mouse over on this, I can see that it's need a parameter as in callback function here, right? We'll see in detail in the next video, do not worry about this, as of this is just a loop here, right? Fine. Now let's say that I want to identify how many characters are there in my string, right? So for that we can use the method called length. Okay, so I'm going to log that, and here I'm going to say str.length, right? Now here length is not a function, it is actually a property. So if I mouse over, you can see it's a property, right? Now it says that it is 18, right? So we got the output as expected, right? Okay. Let's consider that we have a string called space where it has some spaces in front and at the end, right? Let's see that. So let space equal to, within double quotes, first I'm going to have a space here, and then probably he will come, and in the end I'm going to have a space here, right? Now I don't want to include the space, I just want to get only the text from the string. Then probably I can go with the function called trim here. Okay, so I'm going to log that, and space dot trim. Okay, so trim is the method which is going to trim the front and the back of the string. Okay, now please remember here also we have a space in between the words, but it is not going to do that. In trim we can, it will in trim by default it will remove the first and the last space, white spaces. Okay, now I don't want to remove the last space, I just want to remove only the first space. Then you can use the trim left here. Okay, for example, so here I can say trim left, which is going to trim only the left side, that is the, I can say, the very first matching white space. Okay, similarly if you want to trim the in the last one, then probably you can use the trim right here, right? So consider that I'm going to get a character from a particular position, right? So here I'm going to take this example again. So here I'm going to say, let's log this. So log, and here I'm going to say str.charAt, and if I say 0, this is going to return me this w here, right? So 0 in the sense first place, right? So in programming always index starts with 0, right? So here the 0th position is my w. Now consider that I want to pick the last value, okay? So that is e, right? Now how do we pick that? Probably we can get the length, and then we can use that length in the charAt, right? So I'm going to get the length first. So let length len equal to, I can say str.length, right? Now here I have to pass the length, but if I do that, I will get in, say, I will get empty string, right? Because what is the length here? Length is, let's log that. So the length here is 18, right? Now index starts from 0, right? So when I go to the 18th position, there is nothing going to be there, right? So that is why we are getting this as an empty string. So what we have to do, obviously we have to do minus 1, right? So length minus 1, that is going to be 17. Now in the 17th position, I have e as a character here. Okay, fine. Now let's see another method here. So I'm going to use maybe substring, right? Okay, now let's say that I want to get only the welcome from the welcome to let code, right? So for that we can use the split, and we can split by the spaces, and from there we can take the first array value, right? But instead of that, I'm going to show you how to do that in another way, that is using the substring, right? So I'm going to use the log here, str.substring here, and here we have to give the position, starting and the ending position. But keep in mind that here starting position is the inclusive, whereas the ending position should be exclusive, right? So 0 is the inclusive, which means it is going to take from the 0 and it is going to terminate till the last but one, right? So we here, if I see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? We have 7 characters, so 0 to 6, right? But it is exclusive, so I have to do the plus 1 here, right? So that is going to be 7 here, okay? So remember, this is inclusive, whereas this is going to be your exclusive, like it is going to exclude that value, okay, till that value, not that exact value. Okay, so 0 to 7 in the sense it is going to take the first 7 characters, but 0 to 7 is 8, right? But it is going to take from 0 to 7 minus 1, that is 6, 0 to 6. Okay, so I hope you are clear with the substring. Now let's say that I want to remove some character, or I'm going to replace some character. Okay, for example, let's say welcome to let code. Instead of that, I want to say welcome to protractor. Okay, so in that case I'm going to log this, and here I'm going to say str.replace. Now I'm going to say what I want to replace, right? So I'm going to say let code, so let code, and in what character you want to use it. Either it can be a character or it can be a word, right? So I'm going to give a protector here. Okay, so now if you see the output here, so let me hide this. So here you can say welcome to protector. Now in replace, you can also have words, characters, and also regular expressions. We'll see regular expressions in another video. I think this is fine for now. So we have learned all this method, which are going to pretty much helpful in the while doing our test script, right? Now that's it. Even if you go to interview, based on this probably you can solve any answer. And maybe in another video I will also make some of the most repeated questions in string concept. Okay, fine. So we are done with our methods. Now let's come to the reality. That means, what is immutable? You have to understand the very important concept here called immutable, right? Now in general, what is immutable? Unchangeable, right? So we cannot change anything, right? But if you see here, let me take some space here. So I'm going to bring this, okay? Now if let's say that I'm going to convert this to uppercase, right? So str dot to uppercase, right? So to uppercase is the method here, right? Now when we do that, we are able to change the code here, right? We are able to change each and every character within the string, right? Then how it is going to be immutable, right? So you might ask, right, if this is not immutable, right? Immutable means we cannot change the things, right? Now it is true, because if I log the str again, I will see the original character, which is welcome to LetCode, right? You can see the differences, right? When we are going to convert this, it is able to convert, but it is not affecting our original string. That is what immutable is. Now in string, whenever you declare, it is not going to change at any cost until you reinitialize it. Now what does it reinitialize means? For example, let's say that str equal to, I'm going to say hey. Okay, now if I log this here, so then I can see that I am able to change that. Okay, now whatever the functions you are going to apply in the existing string, that is not, that is going to change, but that is not going to affect your original string. Even when you reinitialize the value, it is not going to affect the same memory location. It is going to affect in different memory location. That is how string generally works, right? So I think this is very clear, like immutable. Whenever you are going to give, whenever you are going to do some operations on that, that will not change the original value. That is what immutable. And until you reinitialize the value, okay? I hope this is very clear. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.